Okay. To be very short, Comcomism stands for Common Company. It's somehow related to the talk before. She explained something about what happened in what was in Yugoslavia with something that she called self-managing. I don't know exactly the differences. That's why it would be nice to talk with her, but let me explain what is Comcomism. Comcomism stands for Common Company. The idea is that people can be equal shareholders and with agreement that can resist the capitalistical power taking over it. So the problem, like, the first thing when you think about shareholders, you say, oh, we know this shit, and shareholders, it's easy to manipulate, and big powers with big money can make it somehow. So I will go with you for the 6 points, but the main thing that I want to say in the beginning is that normally in the court, if you make them, if I'm wrong and you are right, and the court say I'm wrong and you are right, still there is question, what is the value of the damage? How much should I pay to you for being wrong to you? And if this is attached to value of the company, the answer is so clear. It's the damage is really the related to the value of the company. So when we make agreement related to shareholding and someone will violate the agreement, the other can go to court and sue not only that the one was not nice or wrong or whatever, but so that the other should pay the value of the damage. So that's why Comcomism actually take advantage on the current system, current whatever you have now. And if we will, if this agreement is good, it might be that the agreement can protect us from the other powers. So here are some principles. Each principle has some reasons, and let me go fast over those principles. So tradability means the ability to sell the share to anyone, beginning with the community, but if the price, if there is no satisfaction in with anyone other, selling the share, in the sale there is value, and that value reflects the value of the unit, so like shareholding is the sale. Why this is important? It is important because of the following. Suppose I have 10 euro share, and I'm not satisfied from you, the executive power, and I would sell to him in 9 euro, that 10 euro share. She can see that 10% of the value of the performance, the performances of the executive power are reduced in now in 10%, and she can see that there is some problems here. So it's a transparent mechanism that brings transparency to the evaluation of satisfaction of the members in the unit. That's why sell your share in to other is advantage. There is another advantage. If I would sell the share, if I have problem, I need money, I can sell the share. I have egoistic reason to sell the share, or my family or whatever. So I have escape. I can care for my own. But while caring for myself, I also care for my other, that equal to me. When I sell, I reflect the value of them, and when others sell, it reflects that value on me. And when I don't sell or get dividend, we all get the same. So we can care for the common and the individual interest in the same way. So this is the point one, totability. Then the point two is about inability to change the contract. So it's like in a GPL contract, there is recursivity in the contract, meaning when the one that buy the sell the share buy it, the one must agree that the one will not change the agreement. That is how it is done practically. And then there is a point of coherent layering. Coherent layering meaning two things: there is layering and it's coherent. Layering means in the position of being equal can be person or another such company. So can be many, many small, many layers, and small companies can build bigger company. And coherent layering mean that one cannot have more than one position through all those layers. This mean if I and he have equal share here, and I and her have equal share here, this and this cannot have equal share nowhere, because I will have two positions. So it's kind of a tree, of which parent is the property and the child is the owner. So we need to care for this current layering. Now come the deal. This is. Okay, we have formula and we have the D. Before I come to the D, I want to say one thing. Cooperative is good for, the way I understand, is good for small homogenic units in which trust is established personally somehow. But when you want to go really big, when you need to buy satellites or roads or things like that, you deal with heterogenic society, conflicting society, one that is, that we are not the same, still we need to own those things or to manage those. So, concomitism is for to enable heterogenic society to own that. That society normally in economic are the customers, and it's targeting customers. Now, customer, as like those that buy beer, they not necessarily know all about producing beer, or those that buy computer, they don't necessarily know all about computer. So there is maybe some possibility to have some coexisting. And the D is about this coexisting. The D is the ratio held by all equal owners or pure owners, meaning it can be 100% or all is owned by only equal owners or less. And the D will reflect that ratio. And so we end up with the formula. And the formula, this is not so.
Okay. Bigger or?
No. The formula. Okay. D is stand for this.
Welcome.
Okay, if we have two circles, and yeah, like this one, the inside is the blue and outside is the red. And we have the equal owners around, and the non-equal owner, ordinary owner, in. then we can ask the following: how much is the ratio of the out of from the in? And that is D. So D multiply I, if I is all the number of shares, will give the number of peers, and the number of shares E multiply the number of shares each peer has. So this picture is where only 30% of the company is held by equal owners, peer owners, and 70% is owned by other, Deutsche Bank for this case. So the idea is that all the owners, including in this case Deutsche Bank, will sign that the D will not be changed, will never be changed. So, because we know that big power can manipulate, all those are measures for against manipulation. So, if we can hold that the D will not change, that Deutsche Bank cannot begin with 30% for the people and then try after that to make 2% for the people. So it's a static D. There is five, is another such measure. Even though only 30% are equal owners, how many they will be there, they will decide by themselves only. So it means, again, Deutsche Bank have 70% here in this example, and we are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 people, 12 people in peer owners. And let's say Deutsche Bank say, hey, nice of you, but it's need more people here. You need to be 2 million. So it is only us to accept it or not. How many we will be. Why? Because for any entry of someone else, we must give a little bit of our share. So we have this power to decide how many we will be. Autonomic power. Okay, now it's become, this is still not so complicated. I want to rest a moment before we go to the last point. The flexibility of the D. But before we go there, we already know a static COMCOM. This is a common company. The D is defined only once in the creation of the company. All the owners of it agree that the D can never be changed. The number of the peers is decided by them alone. And all the other points that we said, tradability, no changing of the agreement, and coherent level. So, before I will not enter the sixth for quite time, a long time now. I want to go to some practice so you can feel it better, and then we'll get to a little bit more complicated. And actually, I go now to another. Okay, so the idea is, so here are some possibility to use this kind of agreement. Let's begin in the following. We are customers, there are producers somewhere, and in between there is market, including TV channel, chain of supermarket, banks, whatever connect product to customers. So let's take one element in the buffer, and here is the proposal. People can implement economical power of boycotting, yet without putting any cent, no money, just the ability to boycott is economical power. They can get organized, signing the agreement that I said, and giving to someone else, the small groups, which are able to own bigger groups, are giving to someone else three parameters. The email of the group, the number of the people, and the entity they want to partner with, and the volume they have there. And someone will accumulate those information, and then will come to a threshold, and the story will be something like, someone will negotiate with something like Aldi and say something like, "Dear Aldi, we're not only going to boycott you or not, 30% of your volume is held by people that signed the following agreement. And what we want is to get partnership with you or with your competitor." And in this way, I believe, we can slowly eat the buffer, and by that alone already change many, many factors. We can change how the producer manipulate the buffer against the customer. We can change within the system itself. This is very massive. This can be done, if it's done by the Occupy movement, it will be a call for the 99% as they are believing in property still, without educating the people still as they are, to be able to change the system. So this is proposal one. Another proposal. In these changes of the system, there is a cycle of privatization, nationalization, etc., and again, privatization, nationalization. So it means that banks are falling, the government put money in the bank, and then they go up, and then they get privatized, and then they are falling, and the government put money, and then they get up, and this is normal cycle. That's what we live. So, please, take a zoom out and see a cycle, and if you see the cycle, you can ask who could be benefiters of that cycle, and you have not so many that could take those positions, and those are those very rich that are getting fitted by governments. And so whenever the government come and say, "We must for rescue the people, we must put money nationalizing an institute," then as a political measure, we can ask exactly what group the government going to rescue now. Because then we can come to exact people, according to the government, that should become equal shareholders in that rescued institute. And why should we do so? Because there is cycle. So when it will be privatized again, it is the people that are going to enjoy it. So it's again playing in the system by the rules of the system with, and now this therefore can go to political parties. Any political party that will understand what I said now and will go in that way will be able to attract many voters only on the issue of, please list the group that the government rescue and make them to be peer owners in a COMCOM of which, in a COMCOM, of the institute being compromised. So all this is called GovComCom. This is the second issue. So we have customer and GovComcomizing. Another issue, certification. So there are, in Berlin and everywhere else, there is the problem of big capitalist power making the value of the place to be higher, and then the people live there have no any option and they go out, etc., etc., etc. This is no problem. So normally people said, yeah, we need to fight it, and yeah, we squat, we make awareness, etc., etc. But here is another proposal, and I need to show it. And then, okay, it's not here. This proposal that I'm going to give here is based on something that I did with investor in Berlin. He was kind of nice investor in Seabase, which is kind of Seabase, I don't know, something. And he said that he have an object, 2 million object in Neukölln, and it is a tobacco factory, and he can buy it, and he wants to make something good with it. And I said, okay, look, if you get, this is like huge object, and there are many big rooms, and I said, I want one room here, in of those big rooms. And if we can feed it with all what we need for media of any kind for the following: activist, artist, and activist, artist, and students, that they are small groups of peer owners. If you can do this, you would get in your object and the environment of that new value. New people will come. They will have a trend of authenticity because they are equal owners there. It will be therefore making, if it's all go well, the value of the land to be higher, and your bank giving you loan will be happy. So he said, yeah, he will do. He didn't get the loan yet, or things happened. Just, I want to give you this so you can understand how it's happened. This is kind of a real thing. And now come the other thing. There are people that are living there in that moment, and they will be, by this program, kicked away. So need to care for them. So here is how. So, okay. Remember the layering. I was very fast on this, but it's very important to understand what is happening. So in this position can be person or another common company. In this position can be person, common company, or non-common company. And so, if we will have one com-com, and those that live in the place will be equal shareholders around it, they will have kind of security net. And then those that are going to make higher value of the land there, those students, artists, etc., they will be com-com inside here. And that will be a company that will care for the place. And that will make that the value of the place, if the value of the place go up, those that live there get something from that, and they are not kicked away as normally done in certification. So this is a capitalistical approach. It will develop the area. It will not deal, it depend on the people, actually. I cannot say what will happen. It's a little bit unknown. But anyhow, they will have the control on that thing. So, in short, this is a way that can give to people in many sides. Like, again, the people that live there, the people that going to come to that place, all of them going to be equal shareholders in different companies that all together provide bigger company. So it means that they will have kind of coexisting in a way, and they will somehow feed each other because it's the same company. I ran away to another, and then we stop and ask me questions because it's like feeding too much. But just it all that is just to show that it can go in from different. It's a game that has many faces. And this is about this is gallery and the artist and etc. etc. So let's go to the artist problem. For this, I want to draw. Apparatus. That get energy and spread it out. Normally it will be heated, yeah? So here is the energy and there is something that spread it out and here is the outer receivers. So it's a heater, normal heater. But if you go economically and you think about energy, I can imagine that those are kind of artists or inventors or developers or those that give something unique to the society. They are the energy. Back to the example of artists, let's be a musician, then the radiator, the one that spread the energy, is the record company or something like that. And then the receivers are the customers. So for any such principle thing, we can make the following. We can make a com-com of the artist to be here. Partnering with the radiator, let's say the record company, where some preferred customer or channels to customer, like for example, given in this gallery, the channels are newspapers, magazines, or maybe schools that bring visitors, so there will be equal shadow. Shareholders after. And now there is question, I'm first asking your question and then I rest. Yeah, if you are Michael Jackson and I'm only me, why would you want to have equal shareholding like me? Or how it can work? So the thing is that we will, all of us will decide equally about the different contracts you're going to have benefiting you better than me, but I will have some benefit from your benefit too. Generally speaking, this hand is more authentic, is more, it's give the art, the one of the big problems of the art today is that it's tool of the few to dominate the many, and this can be that the art will dominant, them will be a tool of the man. Okay, I stop here. Please ask and see.
Second circle, under box the market. No, what you showed now.
Yeah.
Because the companies, music labels and stuff,
yeah.
They sell records or something. And it's, I don't know if it's destroying the structure of this market, structure of the labels, for example, if you have artists who have their own custom, I don't know, because they don't.
Let's go step by step, so I understand your question.
Yeah.
Okay. You are Michael Jackson and I'm me.
I think about the energy.
Okay. Yeah. Well, and we have our small control, and he is the label.
Okay.
Okay. And we partner with him. Until now it's okay.
Okay.
And there are many customers of our music. Now what? And they are in the outer circle.
Okay.
Now where is the problem?
I just don't understand how the economic works if you have this construction.
Okay, actually this can be many layers. This was simply fine in a way. Let's go to this gallery. The moment, the way I understand, just because we were here and we got students from all Germany, it's me, that they didn't know about the change of the program, but they came. So they were scheduled before, okay? So whoever benefit from that schedule should be in the peer owners around. Now, again, there could be another come here. So it's not necessarily person that is there.
Can be a company like a neighbor too.
Here can be a company, here can be other companies.
Okay.
So then you have many other layers.
But there must be a radical change globally and not...
No.
Okay.
No, you don't begin with the system, you begin in yourself. So if I'm... the only thing that we can just show that we are authentic in that sense. So I would link it to be authentic in the system. And then other will be challenged if they are authentic or not. Why authentic, I must say. Here is another example. It's called My Barack Obama Com. It was used to make the President of the United States the President. It has 13 million activists. And I was in the mailing list of that. And I saw how it was effective for a specific time. And then he said, hey, hi, ho, hey, I'm President now. And thank you very much. And I need to transfer the ownership of the My Bank of Amacom domain name to the principal body governing the Democratic Party. I need to change the name from Change America to Organizing America. I need to change the agenda from electing me to whatever I'm going to say. The manager I take also, thank you, bye. So that's, you have there a video of him saying so, and it was done, and then the mailing list was spammed and shit and tra-la-la-la. Before it was very effective mailing list. 30 million people were delivered, transferred to the other place without them able to do anything. All the platform was transferred. If that mailing is stupid thing, if that is owned equally by the people, it cannot transform. It's just, no one can change it. And that gives authenticity, because it means that no any leader under any policy with any kuka shmuka can do that thing that was done.
So idea is to try small and then see.
Yes, and prove it by yourself, and then the other will.
Maybe. Maybe.
Yeah. So I believe. Slow. So again, another such Facebook. Okay, what, who, Facebook, this is the big thing. Again, if they are equal owners of that competitor of Facebook, then it will be a different story.
But the politics controlling who gets the, if the politics are agreeing this, then...
The politics, we don't, the idea here is don't involve yourself, don't talk with politics, make your agreement by yourself and show its work, and the other will be challenged.
It's a fight to survive this way, I think, in our system.
What do you mean it's a fight? It's hard?
It's difficult, it's hard.
It's difficult.
Yeah.
What would be difficult, just to understand?
To get the financial...
We don't need any financial money.
We need food.
No, we don't need...
Okay.
Do you use mailing list?
Yes.
Okay, here is... he is now sleeping, he's so tired, but... We're going to provide a service of compromise mailing list.
trading, what do you say, for example?
What?
Changing.
To include you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Okay. You mean to trade and to help each other? That's one example.
I mean, we can start in what we do already, and that will show to that.
Okay.
See you. Good time, good luck.
Thank you. See you later.
Yes, see you later. Good time, good luck.
Kissing.
Kissing.
Bye.
Bye. So, questions, still questions.
How does it work when people don't use money?
When people don't, it can work without money, still.
Which parts then stay, which change? Because you cannot, yeah, what changes?
Thing about money is a ticket. Okay, it's a ticket. And the ticket have value, so still it's about value, but not necessarily money. It's like a game in that case, and then it will be without tax. There is advantage to do it. The disadvantage in that is, in the beginning I said that when you go to court and there is attached value to the thing, then it's easier to demand, to show the damage, yeah? You understand what I mean?
I can say if you drove over my field of cabbages, I would like to harvest on your field, and we can all again settle without using money. So in the case you were saying about damage or something, you can still, like, someone can say, oh, I gave you a router and now it disappeared. The person say, hey, I want the router back. So it can still can work without using money, cases like you talk about.
So here is the thing, in the end you will transfer this to some money. For like in the code for the damage.
No, that's
okay. So I mean the following. Suppose here's the thing. Suppose we are four people signing agreement, okay, and I sold the agreement to him, and you also sold to him. So, and you both knew that she sold the share to the same one twice, okay. In this case, I didn't violate, but you violate the agreement. Also, he violated the agreement. So we have two people to sue them, and those two can go to court now and say, you might know, not know, but he for sure knew. Now, these are only two. If we have 100 or 1,000 or 100,000 people, each of them is damaged by him, in a specific value, whatever is the value of the company. Then it's really heavy for him to do that. Much more than to come and to. It's possible, it's not possible, it's more expensive in a matter of what kind of lawyer you need to pay for to prove in the court, not between people, in the court, in the bad guy court. This give power to them or to anyone else against him in this case that they violated the agreement. So, so against any one of us that will break the agreement. So there are many in Germany is very nice. There are many laws in Germany. Many can break the agreement. Nothing happened to them. The reason is that there is no attached value to the damage. And if the moment there is attached value to the damage and they know to calculate, I'm going to break the agreement and there are 100,000 that they even know that they're going to do something and the cost is 10 euro multiplied 100,000 is, not for sure I'm going to do it. But if I don't know exactly the value of the damage, I can speculate, I can get lawyer to help me to tell my story, then I might I might give it a try or whatever.
And how looks the death of Comcomist companies. So people say, okay, let's create a COMCOM, and they do an agreement and so on. And they say, okay, let's destroy it. We don't want to work together anymore.
How they dissolve the COMCOM?
How dissolve it or?
This is a very strong question because it's agreed by everyone, and everyone else will be able to sue the other. It's agreed by everyone that the agreement will not be changed. So the agreement will not be changed. What will happen is that it will be simply dissolved. So it will commit suicide. It will.
So if you have a factory or something.
So it will. The assets will be sold. The owner will get whatever they can get from selling the asset, and the title will end its validation. That label will not exist. That is the only. This is, yeah. So the moment it back to the deed, it's like in my imagination, it's not only decentralization property of the unit, it's also the DNA. It's like the stamp of the company. It's like it's such, and it just cannot be different. It's again manipulation. And also, it's for someone from outside can say, oh, this is company, it's COMCOM. And then say, the D is 0.3. 30%, I want maybe 80%. So you have only one parameter. All the tables, everything, for looking for your best choice between all those compromised mailing lists, whatever are there, will be with this D. So it will be a factor too that is to be considered.
So two questions. One is like historic examples that you might find, I mean, like of similar kind of organizations. And another one is, wouldn't be this kind of organization very little flexibility, like a kind of inflexible to different quick changes if you need so many people to agree about what to do?
Okay. The first question, exactly such thing I didn't found. Mm-hmm. But what she said, actually, in Yugoslavia, they had something that actually looked like some similarities, maybe the most similar, somehow. So this is the story. And now we come to flexibility. There was 0.6. Let's go there. It can be flexible by agreement. So we go there. Okay, little mathematics. Remember the formula, okay? Now instead of I, put, oh no, before you put, until now, we talked about the possibility of outer entity to come in to the red or to the blue. You can come as an ordinary owner or as peer owner directly from outside. Let's block it for a moment and say, no, if you want to go to the blue, you first must go to the red. And only cooperating with other such people, peer, you can form another company going to the blue. So it's a no direct access to the blue. And let's do another trick. I will be the number of those members that could do anything in that company. So the number of shares is the number of members. So. Now, the idea is that people can only, companies, Deutsche Bank cannot come in, but individuals can come in as peer owners and then form another COMCOM inside. And by the movement of them from out and in, the D is changing. But now, another mathematical thing. The D is changing, but what interest those from outside have for stepping in? If N is one, they have no interest. It's the same for them when they're outside or inside. So, if N is less than one, then they have interest to go in and they can get something more than those that are outside. So, the same authority that decides about the number of the pills will also decide how much less than one will be N. So they will have kind of a factor in the hand to advance those that can make better for them, but if they fuck up, they can reduce the benefit of that. So now, with those rules, we can talk about actually three possibilities. When D is fixed, we call it S.com.com, it's static company. When you cannot sell the shares outside to the external, not to the pure owner, outside totally, then it's independent com.com, it's I.com.com, it's indie.com.com. When you can sell it outside via the peers, via the position of the peer, then it's dynamic.com, it's a D.com.com. So now we have those three possibilities, and now it's a little bit more flexible. Thank you very much for your listening.